Hey there, time to check in with CoinDesk Global Policy and Regulation Managing Editor Nick Day, who's also the editor of CoinDesk's The State of Crypto newsletter. Hello there, Nick. So just earlier, we were talking about this EU regulation going through EU Parliament. They're clamping down on crypto privacy. Can you give us an explainer of, you know, what's going on there? What's the process? And, you know, how detrimental is this to the crypto industry there?
Good morning. So yeah, yesterday, European Parliament voted to advance a bill that would basically enforce KYC rules on unhosted or self-hosted or private wallets, wallets that you control, crypto wallets that you control, as well as try and bar even small anonymous transactions in crypto. And the sponsor of the bill said that this is because of concerns that crypto could be used for illicit purposes, including smuggling and child exploitation, terrorism, things like that. So the sponsor has, you know, said that these are genuine concerns. This is why the bill has been, you know, created, so to speak. And is also concerned that crypto, you know, transactions could be split up and you can transfer small or large sums of money, sums of crypto with these small transactions. And so, yeah, what's going on next is this is going to be under discussion by various representatives from the different member nations. We're going to see, I think, some continued debate, but it does look like this is well on its way to being a enforceable, kind of a law, basically, across the 27 different European member nations.
Also, Nick, I understand you were also keeping track of the Senate the House Agriculture hearings with CFTC Chair Ross and Benham. Tell us a bit about what happened yesterday.
Yeah, so that was actually really interesting to me, at least. It was an Agriculture Committee hearing, and the CFTC falls under the Agriculture Committee because it oversees things like grain derivatives. But most of the questions, a very large percent of them, were about this FTX proposal to try and clear margined crypto derivative trades, basically. So FTX has, petitioned the CFTC to be able to do this directly without having an intermediary in between. The CFTC has put this out for public comment. It wants the general public to, weigh in, say, okay, we think this is a good idea, we think this is a bad idea, or, we think this is an idea. They have, I think, another 30 days or so to do so. A lot of lawmakers were really questioning, A, is this a genuine advance in technology? Is this a concern? B, is this a risk to the U.S. financial system or to the derivatives market? And then C, just questions about crypto at large. So, CFTC Chair Ross and Benham, he's come out in the past. He said that he believes the CFTC should play a larger role in regulating crypto. He sort of reiterated that yesterday. One lawmaker asked if we were to create a term digital commodity in the U.S. and gave the CFTC the ability to define it and to take first crack at, deciding what cryptos are a digital commodity and what aren't, and therefore what cryptos fall under the CFTC and what doesn't. He said yes. So he's continuing his campaign to try and have the CFTC be the primary federal market regulator for crypto spot markets. He also said that, he doesn't at this moment believe in the FTX proposal necessarily, but that he feels it is his job as a responsible regulator to allow everyone to weigh in, to get as much input as possible before the CFTC makes a decision on this. So very interesting, I think, from a wonkish, policy perspective, but nonetheless, could be a sign of things to come, especially from this particular agency.